Statue of Liberty, mate.
I know, it's mute on it.
It's quite mad that like we're two lads from two small towns.
Aye, cowboys.
Yeah,
cowboys.
Just been, I remember like
looking at Manhattan skyline.
I remember when you first came to the PC and like we were just giggling like little schoolboys, like that. It was like we'd snuck in the back door into like this big huge company, and like it was like the security had turned the other cheek, and we just kind of crept in the back door, you know, or giggling.
100%. Cowboys, modern cowboys, man, that's what it feels like.
And it kind of feels like we've done that in America as well,
key
right?
Key to the kingdom, man. It's mental.
A couple of years ago, we would have been in Glasgow, in some like town hall, and now we're looking at the Statue of Liberty, which is like one of the most iconic symbols of America and kind of like American freedom, I guess, right?
It just feels like the center
of the earth, right?
The earth, and then even more so, New York's like the center of wrestling, really. Like you know, like New York and wrestling are synonymous with each other.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's mad, no? It's,
yeah, I got signed with New York.
I'm going to that New York. But that's, I think what you said, but just when folk would have seen us giggling or whatever, you have to be, I guess, from the type of background that we came from to understand why it's funny, you know what I mean? Like, sometimes I try and explain it to people just the way you explained it there, and they don't get it.
And even, like, getting to, like, see that whole, like, scene behind us really puts it into perspective of, like, how irrelevant, like, all the hustle and bustle around the hotel is, right?
It's mad.
Because there's like people lined up waiting for signatures and pictures and things, and that's great, but this really brings you back down to earth and makes you realize like that there's a lot more going on than just wrestling, you know.